be free?
Yes, my friend. Drained and bled and freed from the prison of the flesh. Free to ascend smoke to the stars.
And the good? The word? How are we saved then?
Show me these worthy, Mandus. Show me these good. I do not see them.
I will rain excrement into your very soul. I will destroy you.
You are too late, Mandus. My great works are almost begun.
I am here again, at the foot of those stairs, towards the red light of the nursery, sunset in the window like a bleeding sky, the horizon a slit throat, the seeping dark, the grain of guilt from us. I am the jaguar-faced man. I am the feathered serpent. This priesthood is mine.
I can meet him, your great engineer. How marvelous. I must say, Mr. Manders, my excitement is almost unseemly.
Yes, I can see that. Step this way, Professor. I will be right behind you.
Manders. Manders, where the devil are you? I can't see a damn thing. Manders!
We are the pig, Professor. They are all the pig.
Stillness now. Blue water runs in my veins, now I am clean. I carry the knife of this factory, the bowl of this mill. I am come to collect you from your fields and your furnaces. I will gather you into the white clouds. I will gather you to me, and I will take you home. save you, only to spare you. I would have given my soul to spare you this world and its loam. Oh, my children. My children. What have I done? What have I become? Sins washed clean. I love you, my darlings, and I am sorry. I am sorry for all I have done. I simply loved you all too much for this world.
Your misguided crusade and let me save them. You may hate me, Mandus, but I have seen the future, your 20th century, and let me tell you this, a far greater slaughter awaits you there. I seek to save the world by blood now, before millions fall beneath history, pushed under by blade, bullet, and gas.
Yeah. world. I am your friend. Manderson, please, I am no more evil than you. We sought the same thing, to save humanity, ridding them of their painful, stupid, pointless lives. Mandus, stop. Think about what you are doing. For your children, Mandus.
Do not speak of my children, Master.
I did not kill your children, Mandus. You sacrificed them at the temple steps, knowing what the last century would do to them. Your sons will drown, lungs full of mud, on the banks of the Somme. You wanted to save them from the hard time. That is the vision we share. Everything we have built to upend this coming nightmare. You and I are ones. We are souls. Our souls are entangled. We deserve to make them free. Into faith. A child's shadow burnt into the brickwork. A house of skulls in the jungle. The innocent Mandus trod and bled and gassed and starved and beaten and murdered and enslaved. This is your coming century. They will eat the Mandus. They will make pigs of you all. And they will bury their scalps into your ribs. And they will eat your hearts. Please, Mandus, no. For your children.
I lay there and watched the god I had created die. At the end, when we were cold as the stone we had hewn his body from, when the lights were nearly all extinguished, we heard, in the silent distance, the man-pigs singing to one another. Then, as the last lights were gone, and we lay together in the deep. They drifted away, and all was silent. Such a silence I have never known. And as the dust settled on my open eyes, and we lay together embraced forever, I heard, miles above us, the sounds of the city turning over in its sleep. A church bell ringing out. And in that moment, the new century was born.